At daybreak, on the first day of the week, the woman who had come from Galilee with Jesus took the spices they had prepared and went to the tomb. They found the stone rolled away from the tomb, but when they entered, they did not find the body of the Lord Jesus. While they were puzzling over this, behold, two men in dazzling garments appeared to them. They were terrified and bowed their faces to the ground. They said to them, "Why do you seek the living one among the dead? He is not here, but he has been raised. Remember what he said to you while he was still in Galilee, that the Son of Man must be handed over to sinners and be crucified and rise on the third day." And they remembered his words. Then they returned from the tomb and announced all these things to the 11 and to all the others. The women were Mary Magdalene, Joanna, and Mary the mother of James. The other who accompanied them also told this to the apostles, but their story seemed like nonsense, and they did not believe them. But Peter got up and ran to the tomb, bent down, and saw the burial clothes alone. Then he went home amazed at what had happened. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
How do you feel? Good? Are you still sweaty? No? No more? Well, I'm still sweaty. Today, let us catch the essence of this night by the readings. It took a little bit of time to hear all of them. Only 1.5 hours to get to the gospel. We're breaking records, huh? So, in the first reading that we saw, there's something to catch. And today I would like to talk especially to the catechumens, three people that today they will join the Catholic faith, the Christian community. I would like to present them to you. Please stand. Crystal, Antonio, Yvette, and Edvaldo, welcome to the faith that we profess. In a little bit more of time, you will start receiving all the life of Christ and all the sacraments in the most blessed night. Be welcome. Please be seated. I would like then to enter to each one of the readings that we heard just to present the glimpses, if we can talk like that, of every one of those readings. The first one you remember, 7 days of creation. And because of that, the number 7 becomes a number of perfection. The entire Holy Scripture it's full of that number, presenting the 7 sacraments, for example. And in that reading, maybe it is for us to recall how every single day finished. It says, and God saw that everything was good. That is a powerful message. He created all in goodness. And then, at the end of all those days, he made a decision of having his own people, his own family. He created us to be part of him. So he gives the 2 gifts that only humans we have. Let us make men and women to our own image and likeness. 2 words that they are powerful for each one of us. The image that we cannot deny it. Check it out. We look like God a little bit, right? Yes. We are his creatures, and we need to celebrate that, the image of God, and that is a gift. But likeness, it is what we are working, my friends. It is what we are working. The image we already have it, but the likeness to behave like him, to feel like him, to look like him, to hear like him, to be tender like him. It is the work of a lifetime, and God gave that to us. And in those days of the first reading, he sets the freedom, the free will. Later we will know how the adventure goes. The adventure goes down, right? Don't touch of that tree. If you eat of that tree, you will know death. And then we go. We are more curious than the cats, right? Ooh, what a nice tree. Ooh, I'm going to be like God. Let's have the fruit, right? The woman then calls the husband, and you know that all husbands, they are obedient, right? Point, 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 point. We fall. But that is not all. In the first reading then, we enter to the story of the Exodus. And in the Exodus, what do we see? People that they were enslaved. They were working for the Egyptians in the constructions of all their things, but they were having a life of slavery. And what happens in that second reading? That second reading, it is not only the celebration of the people of Israel leaving Egypt and getting a new land. Don't be confused. That celebration, it is not something to be celebrated historically. Ooh, 3,000 years ago, and we celebrate that. No, that is the announcement of your own freedom. It is passing from slavery through the waters. You remember that text. The Lord separates the waters, and the people of God, they go through. And the evil the Egyptians, that they were trying to catch them, they are not able to grasp them. The Lord protects. What is that calling? It is calling the people of God to have that freedom, to pass through baptism, right? And through those waters that they produce the liberation, we go to the promised land. It is an announcement of heading back to the kingdom of God. As I like to say sometimes, or do you like it down here? You want to stay down here? 1,000 years down here. How good is that? You get older, and me and the priests, Father Fernando and Diego, we know that very well, because we have to hear people. And we receive messages from people telling, Father, can you pray so that I die? I want to go to God. I'm ready. We hear people like that all the time. It is true. There is a moment in life that you saw all, and it's enough for you down here. And you start to call the realms of God. I would like to go back to God. And in that way, let me move in here so my memory doesn't fail in here. Yep. We start walking and getting the ideas of the prophet Isaiah. So think like this. What do we have? God created all in perfection. We fall. But with that fall, we don't stay fallen. We lift up our hearts. We say that in the Mass all the time. The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. You see why? Because we are not people to be on earth, falling there and staying there, playing. No, we lift up our spirits. So the prophet Isaiah will call the feelings of God, and God is telling, whoever is thirsty, come to the water, come to me. Even the Lord Jesus later, because this is Old Testament, he will say, whoever is tired, come to me, and I will give you rest. Because my yoke is light, and my burden, light. You see, the Lord is making a call for all of us. And with the prophet Isaiah, you receive the baptism today, my dear catechumens. But it is not only that. Then you are going to nurture your spiritual life, and you will have more sacraments to give life, to come to the waters of the ones that are thirsty. And in that way, I would like then to say something more, that for me, it is a mystery. It is a mystery, and only in heaven we will understand that. I don't think God is going to reveal that. And it is a question that I have for him. If he is God, he is already happy. He is the Lord. You know, like my happiness, it is not the condition for him to be happy. He is already happy. That is the definition of God. God is love, and there's nothing we can do to change that. And for me, it is a wondering that in the times that he was not in need of us, he make himself needy. He make himself needy of you and I. How could it be? How could it be that we, in the style of life that we have, and in the many weaknesses that we have, God makes the decision to come to us, to lift us up. So there's something that it is called the old creation. Do you remember the Genesis? And God saw that all is good. But then in the, how do you say pregón pascual in English? You don't know English? Okay. So the priest, well, in the proclamation of the Paschal Triduum, you remember the long song with Father Diego and you in here singing, right? There was a word that it is for us to mark. So the old creation was very good. But now that music, it tells that the new creation, it's more powerful, more beautiful, better in all the ways. So that song says, blessed be the sin that brought to us the Savior. Blessed be the sin. Can you believe that? Who would bless sin? That is only from God. The fall, the weakness that we had, God converted that in the graces to go back to Him. And that is the new creation. Now, the creation, it is not only words. Let it be. Let it be. Now creation, it has a pay. It has a payment. And it is the blood of Christ. It is the blood of Christ. And not only that, the resurrection of the Lord. So that the new creation, it's much better. Don't you think like that? Yes, of course. So now, that old creation, and God saw that all was good. Now we could say with God, the new creation is much better. Praises be to God. Finally, because I like to preach long, right? I would like then to touch a little bit of the gospel. And it is something that for me, it's so tender from God. It's impressive. In the story of the fall, who was the first person to listen to the wrong words? The woman, right? The woman, right? So what is God now doing? Now that He comes back to resurrection, who is the first one to announce that? The woman, you see? So we fall in disobedience as an entire race, but God is so powerful and merciful that the same elements of fall, now He uses in His kindness the same elements to lift up, to go back to Him. And also I would say, because women, they have better communication skills, right? It's true. So the Lord will say, go to my disciples and tell them that I have resurrected, I'm back. Women, they go with that wonderful power that they have to chit-chat, right? He is back. He is back. He has come back from death. Let us celebrate the life of Jesus. Let us be Catholics with the power to change the world. I would like to say finally, if Jesus was able to change the world with 12, He will do something greater with all of us because He has the power and the mercy to do it.
No more homily, yes? Yes, it's enough, yes?
Who wants?
It's enough for everyone, yes? Okay.
Who wants to hear Fire Fernando?
Five. Only one word, no more. I have support. In Spanish, yes, but I have support. El padre Iván me quitó todo lo que yo iba a decir en el día.
Father Ivan took everything I was going to say.
Pero es inevitable en una noche como esta tratar de pensar qué piensa Dios de nosotros.
But it's inevitable in a night like today to think about what He thinks about us.
Porque es muy importante trasladarnos por un momento al pensamiento de Dios.
Because it is rather important to transport ourselves to the thinking of God.
Porque es la manera en que podemos entendernos.
Because it is the manner in which we can understand ourselves.
Por eso San Agustín decía de una manera tan acertada, que yo te conozca para que yo me conozca.
That is what St. Augustine would say in such a rightful way, that I might know you so I might know myself.
Solamente conociendo a aquel que nos ha pensado, amado, deseado y creado, podremos entendernos.
Only knowing He who made us, created us, and loves us, can we start to understand ourselves.
Estas palabras del Génesis que hemos escuchado hoy, de que Él nos creó a su imagen y semejanza.
Those words that we heard from Genesis today, that He made us to His image and likeness.
Yo quiero preguntarles a ustedes, ¿qué nos hace semejantes a Dios?
I want to ask you, what makes us similar to God?
¿Qué nos hace como Él?
What makes us like Him?
Aún siendo tan pequeños.
Even though we're so small.
¿Qué nos da su grandeza?
What gives us His greatness?
¿Qué puede elevar nuestra condición?
What can elevate our condition?
Que puede darnos tal dignidad.
What can give us such dignity?
Incluso para poder llamarnos hijos de Dios.
Even to be called sons of God.
¿Qué nos hace hijos de Dios?
What makes us sons of God?
¿En qué consiste el ser de Dios en nosotros?
What does it mean to be God in us?
¿Cuándo soy imagen de Dios?
When am I image of God?
Es fácil. No den muchas vueltas.
It is easy.
Muy bien. Cuando lo que nos hace imagen y semejanza de Dios es el amor.
What makes us to the image and likeness of God is love itself.
Pero no es cualquier amor.
But it's not just any love.
No es el amor hormonal.
It's not the hormonal love.
Ese que ustedes dicen que le da cosquillita en el estómago.
The one that you say gives us a tingle in your stomach.
Ese no es el amor verdadero.
That is not the true love.
Ese sería simplemente un amor corporal.
That would only be a bodily love.
Por eso cuando alguien le diga te amo, usted pregunte cómo, porque.
So when somebody says I love you, you say how do you love me?
Es importante saber con qué órgano nos aman, con el intestino.
It is important to know with which organ they love us, with the intestine or.
Es importante comprender entonces que ese amor se identifica con el amor.
It is important then to understand that that love identifies itself with the love.
Sin el amor no existe el amor.
Without the love, love itself does not exist.
Por eso los hombres cometemos un grave error cuando tratamos de amarnos sin el amor.
That is why we commit such a grave error when we try to love each other without love himself.
Nadie puede amar sin él.
No one can love without him.
Y más aún, nadie puede ser sin él.
And more so, nobody can be without him.
Por eso es importante encontrarlo a él.
So it is important to find him.
Para que él nos dé la alegría de ser nosotros.
So that he gives us the joy to be ourselves.
Uno de los milagros más hermosos que nos da el encontrar a Cristo.
One of the most beautiful miracles that gives us to find Jesus.
Es básicamente porque encuentro mi alegría.
It is basically because I find my happiness, my joy.
La alegría de ser yo.
The happiness to be myself.
Y de bendecirlo por haberme hecho como soy.
And to bless him for making me the way I am.
¿Usted sí se siente satisfecho consigo mismo?
Are you satisfied with yourself?
Mírele la cara al otro a ver si tiene cara de satisfacción.
Look to the face of the next person to see if they're satisfied. They have a satisfied look about themselves.
Dios se esmeró lo suficiente.
God worked hard enough.
Por eso la primera lectura dice, y todo lo hizo bien.
And that's why the first lecture says, and he did everything good.
A esa persona que está a su lado, Dios también la hizo bien. Mire
that
otra vez.
Person that is next to you, God made him good. That's what.
Aunque a usted a veces le caiga mal.
Even though sometimes they don't like you.
Pero Dios le hizo bien.
But God made him good.
Cada uno de nosotros es un bien para sí mismo y un bien para el otro.
Each one of us is a goodness for ourselves and goodness for the other one.
Yo soy una bendición para mí mismo, pero también soy una bendición para ti.
I am a blessing for myself, but I am also a blessing to you.
Dígale al que está al lado, tú eres una bendición para mí.
Say to the person next to you, you are a blessing to me.
No tenga miedo, vuelva y dígalo, dígalo.
Do not be afraid, look again and say it.
Tú eres una bendición para mí.
You are a blessing for me.
Dios nos ha creado con amor, en el amor, para el amor.
God has made us with love, through love, for love.
Realmente nos recreamos cuando nos amamos.
We really recreate ourselves when we love.
Amarnos nos hace felices.
To love each other makes us happy.
Porque es una forma de estar renaciendo en el amor.
Because it's a way to renew ourselves in love itself.
Si nos pasáramos toda la vida únicamente amando,
and we spend all our lives only loving,
seríamos mejores personas.
We would be better people.
¿Qué nos hace malas personas?
What makes us bad persons?
El desamor, la carencia de amor.
The lack of love.
El vacío de amor, las heridas de amor.
The emptiness of love, the wounds of love.
Podríamos decir que esas realidades nos oscurecen.
We could say those realities darken our souls.
Nos opacan.
They make us dark inside.
Y tristemente nos hacen, nos convierten en seres impenetrables.
And sadly they make us like beings that are impenetrable.
Casi podríamos decir que a veces podrían llamarnos seres oscuros.
We could almost say that they could call us dark beings.
Personas tenebrosas.
Persons of the dark.
Hay una frase que le llaman con la que llaman a los novios, los papás de los hijos, de las hijas sobre todo. Dicen, tiene un tinieblo usted.
There is a phrase that the fathers of their boy, speaking about the boyfriends of their daughters, refer to them as, you have certain darkness about you.
No es fácil traducir eso, ¿eh?
It's not easy to translate that.
Y es una forma, podríamos decir, no, lo malo es que nos acostumbramos a ser oscuros.
And it's a way I would say, well, the bad thing is that we get used to being in the dark.
Acostumbrarnos a ser tristes.
We get used to being sad.
Acostumbrados a ser complicados.
We get used to be complicated.
Y esto hace que las personas tengan miedo de nosotros.
And this makes people afraid of us.
Porque interpretan en nosotros realidades que no ven claras.
Because they see ourselves realities, in us realities that they cannot make as clear.
Es así como esa hermosa lectura que el padre Iván nos explicaba de el libro del Éxodo.
Is that a beautiful reading that Father Ivan explained to us about the book of Genesis?
Éxodo.
Exodus.
Nos explicaba que hay que liberarnos.
It says that we must be liberate ourselves. We must liberate ourselves.
La esencia del cristianismo es que viene a liberarnos.
The essence of Christianism it comes to liberate us.
¿De qué nos va a liberar? De todo lo que nos deshumaniza.
What would it liberate us from everything that makes us less human?
De todo lo que nos hace inhumanos.
And what makes us inhumane.
Es decir, de todo aquello que nos desfigura.
And that is to say, of everything that disfigures us.
Y que nos hace proyectar una realidad oscura de nosotros.
And it makes us project a dark reality about ourselves.
Y usted, la verdad, no es tan oscuro.
And you truly are not that dark.
Mire otra vez para el lado.
Look again next to you.
Algo de luz tiene, ¿o no?
Some light must he have, doesn't he?
Pero esta es la noche en que debemos redescubrir nuestra vocación.
But this is the night that we must rediscover our vocation.
Nuestra vocación a ser luz.
our vocation to be light.
Y hacer luz en la transparencia de nuestro ser.
And to be light in the transparency of our being.
Eso quiere decir que quien nos mire sepa a qué atenerse con nosotros.
That means when somebody looks at us, they should know what to expect.
Que seamos seres humanos que iluminan la realidad.
That we might be human beings that illuminate reality.
Lo que pasa es que esa palabra solo la dicen cuando están enamorados.
Those words you only say when you're in love, though.
Pero dice, tú me iluminas.
You illuminate me.
O me eliminas.
Or you eliminate me.
Pero de verdad, estamos llamados a iluminar.
But truly, we're called to be light.
Y hay una secuencia hermosa esta noche que ustedes la han escuchado. Ha sido, pasamos de la liturgia de la luz, de la hermosa liturgia de la luz.
And there's a beautiful sequence tonight that you have listened to, that we pass from the beautiful liturgy of the light,
la cual habla de nosotros,
which speaks about us,
porque somos hijos de la luz.
Because we are sons and daughters of the light.
Tú eres un hijo de la luz.
You are a son of the light.
Díselo al de al lado, tú no eres hijo de las tinieblas.
Say to the person next to you, you're not a son or daughter of darkness.
Vuelve y dígaselo. Usted es un hijo de la luz.
Say again to him, you're a son of the light.
Ilumine.
Illuminate.
Por ser hijos de la luz, estamos llamados a vivir en la luz.
For being sons and daughters of the light, we are called to live in the light.
Y ser luz es ser alegría.
And to be light is to be happiness.
Ser gozo y esperanza.
Say, to be joy.
Y estamos llamados a iluminar a otros.
And we're called to illuminate others.
Pero obviamente una persona que no tiene no puede dar.
But a person that does not have it cannot give it.
Ese sentido porque la liturgia de la iglesia nos llevó después de la liturgia de la luz.
That's why the liturgy of the church took us from the liturgy of the light.
A la liturgia de la palabra.
To the liturgy of the word.
Porque la palabra nos ilumina.
Because the word lights our lives.
Porque la palabra nos enciende en la verdad.
Because it lights up in the truth inside of us.
La palabra nos lleva a la verdad.
The word takes us to the truth.
Y nos inspira la verdad.
It inspires the truth in us.
Y la verdad es el camino de la sanación.
And the truth is the way of healing.
Y la verdad es un camino de liberación.
And the truth is a way of liberation.
Pregúntele esto al del lado.
Ask the person next to you.
¿O usted no se siente oprimido viviendo en la mentira? Dígale.
Don't you feel oppressed living in a lie?
Es hora de vivir la verdad.
It's time to live in the truth.
Y la verdad es la palabra de Dios.
And the truth is the word of God.
Esa palabra que penetra en nuestro corazón y se hace vida.
It's that word that penetrates in our heart and makes itself alive.
Es una palabra que nos sana.
It is the word that heals us.
Que nos enseña a ser mejores.
That teaches us to be better.
Que nos forma.
That forms us.
Nos madura.
It matures us.
Y hace de cada uno de nosotros.
And makes each one of us.
Semillas de vida.
Seeds of life.
Porque esa es la labor de la palabra de Dios.
Because that's the labor of the word of God.
Fecundar mi vida.
To seed our lives.
Nutrir mi vida.
To nourish our lives.
Enriquecer mi vida.
To enrich my life.
Para que yo pueda enriquecer la vida de los demás.
So I can enrich the life of others.
Y por eso esa palabra que hemos recibido hoy es una palabra que nos muestra un camino claro.
And that, for that reason, the word that we have received today shows a clear path.
Por eso el Señor también nos va a decir en la última lectura, como decía el Padre Iván, vengan y beban.
That is why the Lord will say to us in the last lecture, like Father Ivan said, come and drink.
Pero beban del agua viva.
But drink from the life, from the water of life.
Sin embargo, pone una condicional. Dice, mis caminos no son tus caminos.
But he places a condition. My ways are not your ways.
Tus criterios no son tus criterios.
My criteria is not your criteria.
Eso quiere decir de una manera mucho más sencilla esto.
That means in a more simple way this.
tus caprichos. Dígaselo al de al lado para que suene más bonito.
Your desires.
Dígaselo. Tus caprichos.
Your desires.
Y terquedades.
And hard-headedness.
No son los deseos de Dios para ti.
Are not the wishes of God for you.
Es importante que entendamos, Dios tiene una voluntad.
It is important for us to know that God has a will.
Y esa voluntad es nuestra felicidad.
And that will is our happiness.
Pero como decía el apóstol Pablo, si no cambias tu manera de pensar,
but as the apostle Paul said, if you don't change the way you think,
jamás vas a cambiar tu manera de vivir.
You will never change the way you live.
Y hay personas que no quieren cambiar su manera de pensar.
And there are persons that do not want to change the way they think.
Son cerradas.
They're closed-minded.
Trancadas.
Closed-minded.
Y clausuradas por dentro.
And closed up in the inside out.
Menos mal que tiene buenos recursos para traducir. Por favor, abra su mente y abra su corazón.
Please open your hearts and minds.
Sea un poco más dócil a la acción de Dios.
Be a bit more docile to the action of the Lord.
Dios quiere mucho más con usted.
The Lord wants a lot more with you.
Pero quiere que usted también quiera.
But he wants us to want it. So.
Y que usted se disponga.
And for you to allow it.
Hoy nos invita a venir a él con alegría.
Today he invites us to come to him with joy.
A venir con él con esperanza.
With hope.
Y con una solo con una decisión en el corazón.
And only with one decision in the heart.
Esa se debe cumplir hoy para todos.
That it must happen today for all.
Dígalo conmigo.
Say it with me.
Señor, quiero morir al hombre viejo.
God, I
want. Quiero morir al hombre viejo.
Lord, I want to die to the old man.
No, pero créalo, créalo.
But believe it.
Dígalo, dígalo como una plegaria de verdad que sale de su corazón.
Say it as a prayer.
Dios, quiero morir al hombre a la mujer vieja. Dígalo, dígalo, dígalo. Dígalo.
Lord, I want to die to the old woman in me.
Y quiero nacer a la criatura nueva.
I want to be born to the new being.
Pensada por ti.
Thought for by you. Thought
soñada
by
por ti.
Dreamed of you.
Deseada por ti.
Desired by you.
Si alguno de los que está aquí voltea y le mira a usted.
If one of the ones here turns around and looks at you.
Podría concluir que usted sí refleja a la persona deseada, soñada. Y amada por Dios.
Could that person realize that you reflect the person that was wished for, dreamt for, and loved by God?
Estos jóvenes, por ejemplo, hoy van a renacer.
These young people today are going to be born again.
Van a renacer en Cristo.
They're going to be born again in Christ.
Tienen otra oportunidad. Hoy queda en cero el contador de la edad.
Today, the counter of life starts in zero. The mileage starts in zero.
Van a poder estrenar vida nueva.
You're going to be able to break in a new life.
Porque hoy van a recibir el nacimiento en aquel que le da vida nueva. ¿Sí? Vida nueva.
Because today you will receive the birth in he who gives new life.
Eso es el bautismo, nacer de nuevo.
That is a baptism, to be born again.
Cada vez que usted se confiesa, renueva su bautismo.
Every time you confess yourself, you renew your baptism.
Y nace de nuevo.
And you're born again.
Yo quisiera que todo el mundo viviera con la misma cara.
I wish everyone would live with the same face.
Todos los días.
Every day.
Con la que sale del confesionario.
With the face that they live at the confession booth.
Porque ese es el rostro de la persona liberada.
Because that is the face of the liberated person.
Perdonada.
Forgiven.
Y amada por Dios.
And loved by God.
Por eso hoy inspirémonos también nosotros en esta noche gloriosa.
For that reason, let us inspire ourselves tonight in this glorious evening.
Estamos llamados a un destino de gloria.
We are called to a destiny of glory.
Nuestro Señor ha vencido a la muerte.
The Lord has defeated the death.
Y con ella ha vencido todos los enemigos de la muerte.
And with it, he has defeated all the enemies of death.
Ha vencido el pecado.
He has defeated sin.
El odio.
Hate.
El desamor.
The lack of love.
La tristeza.
Sadness.
La amargura. Ha vencido.
Sourness.
No se me quede, hermano. Ha vencido todos nuestros enemigos.
He has defeated all of our enemies.
Y ha resucitado.
And he has resurrected.
Por nosotros.
For us.
Para nosotros.
For us.
Para que tengamos otra oportunidad.
So that we will have another opportunity.
No un día.
Not one day.
Sino siempre.
But always.
Así que siempre que lo quieras.
So always that you want it.
Puedes resucitar.
You can resurrect.
Puedes volver a nacer.
You can be born again.
Porque él lo puede todo, absolutamente
todo. Because he can do it all, absolutely all.
Y lo puede en ti.
He can do it in you.
Por eso dile hoy, Señor, yo creo.
Because, and so say to him today, Lord, I believe.
Y profeso mi nueva vida contigo.
And I profess my new life in you.
Quiero nacer hoy contigo.
I want to be born again today and in you.
Porque hoy decido morir contigo.
Because today I decide to die with you.
Para que tú me des nueva vida.
So that you can give me new life.
Amén.